So now we're generating the table of contents, but we're doing it by building some HTML and then setting the inner HTML of our table of contents box. And that's fine, but this is a module on DOM. So let's use DOM to do it instead. And it's actually slightly more efficient to do it directly using DOM instead of using inner HTML, because you avoid the step where the HTML has to get parsed. And this is a fairly small chunk of HTML, so it's not a huge deal. But in a bigger document, it might actually be an issue. So I'm going to start by, I notice that there's some duplication here of this text. And right now it's not that important, but when I'm using DOM, it will be easier to understand what's going on if I refactor this a little bit and add a couple more helper functions. So I'm going to start with a function called addListItem, and it's going to take a node. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to have the current UL that I'm modifying in this headers array. And so it's going to be the last one that I'm going to want to add my list item to. So we're going to go headers sub headers.length minus one. So that's going to be the last UL. And then we're going to add child. I'm sorry, we're going to append child to that. And then the child we're going to append, we're going to have to build. So let's do that next. So child is going to be a new li tag. And then we're going to set the inner text of the child to node.innerText. And we're actually going to come back to this as well, because we're going to want to make some improvements. But that should be pretty much it for now. And then I'm going to change these lines to call my addListItem of node. And same thing here. And then I think that's it. Okay, so then this code is going to add a level. And let's start by moving this into another helper function called addLevel. And then here, instead of adding a UL to the HTML, what we're going to do is we'll create another child. This time it's going to be an unordered list. And then we're going to push that on headers. Then we're going to call addListItem. And we're also going to push level. So we need level as well here. And then here, we're going to remove level. And this is going to take node and possibly level. We'll find out. And then we don't need to add a closing tag in DOM. We just need to pop the last header. Like so. Okay, so that's a little cleaner. And now here, this is going to call remove level as well. And actually, we don't need node there. So let's get rid of that. Good. So let's see if it still works. Not quite. So let's go ahead and yeah, at the end here, I need to set the table of contents to include my root UL. So let's actually go ahead and put a breakpoint here and see what we have. So here's my JavaScript. Okay, so right here. And then here's where we're updating the table of contents. So I'm going to reload. And then let's take a look at what we have in our local variables. So headers, that's going to be our UL. We pop the last one off. Levels should just have a zero in it. So what we need to do is not remove these levels, but just get the first one. So let's not remove the levels. And let's set document.getElementById table of contents dot append child header sub zero. So that's the root UL. Okay, a little closer, but let's go ahead and put a breakpoint in there again. Okay, so here's my headers, here's my UL, and it's got one child, which is just the node. So it's got one LI under there, but nothing else. So when I go to add the level here, let's take a look at what's going on there. So child is create element UL, headers.push. I also need to append it to the previous UL. So headers sub headers.length minus one dot append child. And then I'm only going to do that if headers.length is greater than zero. Okay, so that's the code that adds this UL to the parent UL. And reload. There we go. Okay, so that's working. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at why this is happening. So if you, this is the H1. So let's go ahead and look at the H1 node. So there's one of those, and we'll get the first one, and we'll open it. So basically, what's happening is Eloquent JavaScript is a piece of text, And then there's a div box with second edition inside of it. But there's no space between those. And when I call inner text, whether I get any white space from this div box or not depends on how it's displayed, whether it's a block or in line. And this hasn't been styled at all at this point. This is in the, well, it has now in the document, but I'm actually looking at the one in contents. And the one in contents, none of the styles work yet because I haven't fixed the URLs when this thing exists. So what I need to do is basically find all the text under this H1 and then glue it all together with spaces between the texts. So if I do H1 dot inner text, here I get white space. I get a carriage return because this is the styled version that's in my current document. But if I go ahead and put a breakpoint right after parse page, so that I can get contents. And that's not the right contents. Let me actually, here's what I'm going to put that inside of parse page. So parse base, parse page, a breakpoint here, continue, and then reload. So now I should have access to contents. Yeah, so there's my document. And I'm going to do the same exact thing as I did before with document, except I'm going to use contents now. So you see, the styled version in the document has a carriage return because the div box has been styled as a block. But contents has no styling information because the URLs are broken. And so the div box is not a block. And what I end up with is no white space from that div box. Okay, so a little technical explanation, but let's continue. So what I want to do is I'm going to add another helper function to my build table of contents. And I'm going to call this scrape text. And it's going to take a node. And what it's going to do is if node.nodeType == document.textNode. So if this is already a text node, then I'm just going to return node.nodeValue. So return the text. And hold on a sec. Okay, so that's. Let's go ahead and call child nodes. So the first one is a text node, and the node type is 3, which is document.textNode, and then the node value is just that piece of text. Otherwise, if it's an element tag, I'm going to have a loop here. Child nodes.length. So for each of the child nodes, I'm going to set result plus equal a space plus scrape text of the child node. So this is a recursive routine as well because it has to walk down the tree and find all of the text, even if it's buried. And then return result. So that should find all the text and put spaces between it. And then instead of using intertext here, I'm going to call scrape text on node. And now since this only happens in one place, I only have to change it in one place. So let's give that a shot, see how it works. Good, so I have a space now in Eloquent JavaScript second edition. So I made one mistake here in my scrape text function. I forgot to declare result. So let me fix that. Should work okay, but you don't want to have a global variable. And then I also want to test this on a page that doesn't have any headers at all, just to make sure it doesn't break, because I sort of suspect it will. So a page that has no headers, and CIS 133W week 7. Let me just go to new document, and I'm going to So I'm just going to save that in week 7 as test page.html. And then I'm going to go back to my fetch page, and that's localhost. CIS 133W week 7 test page.html. Return. Okay, so let's go ahead and so fail to execute append child on node parameter 1 is not of type node on this line. So it's trying to find this thing here, which is nothing, doesn't exist. And so append child doesn't work. So what we want to do is make sure if header sub 0, then we're going to do that. And it worked. And I'm also going to get rid of this black border around my content div, and I'm going to put 5 pixels of padding on it. So let's go and find my contents and get rid of the border padding 5 pixels. Okay, good. So let's go and make sure it still works here, and it seems to. All right, so that's it for this part.